Have you ever wondered how Bring Me the Horizon turned this simple, kinda boring melody into this awesome intro? Hi, I'm Stefan from Mix66, and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can recreate one of the most iconic sounds in modern metal, the intro of Bring Me the Horizon's Throne. Let's jump straight into the DAW. So here we have a little project I prepared for this demonstration. As far as I know, Bring Me the Horizon used Native Instruments plugins to create these sounds. Maybe Massive, I don't know exactly. But for this demonstration, I will limit myself to Serum. Just for fun, there's no real reason to it. Let's start with the lead sound. I used the Hypersub preset in Serum and made some changes to it. I used basically three oscillators. Oscillator A is a kind of a wobbly saw, oscillator B is a basic saw, and I'm also using the sub-oscillator with a square wave. Note that the octave shift is at zero. Both the main oscillators have a unison of 3 with a little bit of detune, and the blend is fairly even, so all the voices have the same loudness. If we listen to the original sound, we can hear that there's a lot of distortion on it. I will add a lot of distortion later on, but I also choose to use the noise function inside Serum. I choose the paperback noise, which adds a nice texture to the sound. This sound will be the starting point to get near the original Bring Me the Horizon lead sound. Next, I add some effects inside Serum. I started with the hyper effect that makes the sound larger and more epic. Okay, this is subtle, but the next effect will alter the sound quite drastically. I added the distortion effect inside of Serum, the drive is nearly at max, 94%, and I added the filter, which filters at almost 9 kHz pre-distortion. Lastly, I added an EQ to boost a little bit around 1K. Next, I want to add even more distortion with the capitator. Also here I have the drive at 10 and also the punish button on, which adds even more distortion. The next plugin is, in my opinion, the most important one, the Tremolator. This tremolo sound gives this Throne intro the iconic sound. Listen to it with it engaged. Now we're getting somewhere. If you want to recreate this pattern, click on Tweak. Make sure Smoothing is None, so you get this kind of shape. And down here you have the Rhythm Editor. Choose 2 bars with 4 beats, and now you are looking at bar 1. The grid should be at 32nd notes. Now you can just click on the 32nd notes here and choose where you would like to mute the sound. So I did this to recreate the original Throne pattern. Next, I added the EQ to filter out the highs and the lows and to add some 703k. Without the EQ and with the EQ. Before we go to the next plugin, listen once again to the original. You can hear that the lead sound jumps from left to right in the stereo field. To recreate this, I use Panman from Sound Toys. You could also do this with automation, but I thought it would be easier to just use the panner. I automated the bypass of this plugin to make sure that the first note is in center, and only after the first note the sound will get moved in the stereo field. You can also see when I press play that the plugin is first in bypass, and then after the first note it will engage. You can also hear that the first note is in the center and then it starts to moving around. And the last plugin on the lead was Little Plate, also from Sound Toys, just to add a little bit of reverb. Okay, listen once again from where we started, just with the basic sounds. To where we are now. So after all these effects, I would say that the Tremolator is the most important one to recreate the sound. This unique tremolo pattern makes this intro really special. Now here's a little tip from my side. I often use Sound Toys Tremolator with exactly this preset on pads or even reverbs. This can add a lot of excitement and drive to a track, almost like a shaker, but without sounding too obvious. I will show you shortly in another project what I mean. Here I have a simple pad. Listen to it without Tremolator on it. And now listen once again with Tremolator and this exact throne preset on it. So let's jump back to recreating the throne intro. Next up we have a bass. Again, I used Serum as a synthesizer, but a very important plugin here is Microshift, again from Sound Toys. This makes the sound wide and stereo. Listen to it without Microshift and all the other plugins on. Now with Microshift, you can hear it makes the sound wider and also some kind of hollow. Next plugin is again Decapitator, Punish button on, drive at 10 to make it heavily distorted. I then use the EQ to carve out some mids and to cut the highs. And also here Little Plate from Sound Toys to add a little bit of depth. Note that the mix is quite high on this one. Listen to where we are now. Okay, we are getting there. But there are still a few things missing. Listen once again to the original. It's not easy to spot it in the original, but if you listen closely, you can hear that there's some kind of reverb piano in it. I've tried to recreate this in Serum with this plug sound. And now, together with the lead and the bass. Okay, so now let's listen to the original and then switch back to our recreation. It's not exactly the same, but I think we are in the ballpark. Maybe the pad is a bit too loud compared to the original, so let's lower that. Now, for the second part, the first thing we recreate is this drum fill. And here's my recreation of it. Again, using Serum and the 808 kick preset. I also added a high cut to make it sound more like the original kick. And again, Little Blade from Sound Toys for a bit of a reverb. Now the original. It is a bit too loud, so let's lower it. We are almost there. Now just three tracks are missing. One of it is the bass. I guess that in the original it is a bass guitar which plays quarter notes. But as I wanted to use only Serum, I recreated a similar sound in Serum. Again, I added the high cut to get rid of the highs. And now all together. Compare it to the original. Now just two tracks are missing, and also for the hi-hat I used Serum to recreate it. What I did was I used the noise function and disabled all the other oscillators. I used the icon hat A sound and modulated the level based on the velocity. Listen to just the hi-hat. It sounds like a real hi-hat. So let's listen to where we are now. Pretty close. Only one thing is missing, and that is the cymbal swell. And of course, also this was made using Serum. I used only the noise section of Serum, and I used the S sound. This time, a LFO with this shape is used to modulate the level. This makes the rising sound. We now have reconstructed the intro. Let's take a final listen to the original and then compare it to our version. And now, the final listen to the recreated version using only one synthesizer, Serum. So there you have it. This is my recreation of Bring Me the Horizon's Throne intro. I hope my tools and my techniques inspire you to create your own awesome music. And if you are a music producer who wants to take their career to the next level, then I have something truly special for you. As music producers, we often get caught up in the daily grind of producing music, and we lose the big picture view. We don't have the self-awareness to identify our blind spots or weaknesses. And that is why I have created the Mix66 Career Diagnosis, a 4-part questionnaire that helps you identifying your strengths and your weaknesses as a music producer. You will get guides with additional resources and valuable insights so you can build a long-lasting and sustainable career as a music producer. Just click the link in the description and start the questionnaire. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and see you next time.